Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I think I am echoing, I don't know. This is my first time of filming in this room, so if you think I'm echoing, please pardon me. I just needed this space to clear my head and shoot this video here. As you have already seen in the caption, I'm going to be talking about that one time I goofed. This is a story time and I hope you guys enjoy it. So if you're yet to subscribe to my channel, please hit the subscription button. Also turn on post notifications so that you can get alerts whenever I post new videos. And my face is shining. If you guys think my face is shining, that's just because I decided to take my skincare routine more seriously. So you're going to be seeing a lot of shiny faces from now on. Anyways guys, so let's just move straight into the video. So before I start with this video, I think I'm already tired of coming here to apologize for not being consistent, always saying I'm sorry, I've been busy. Guys, anytime I post, I beg, just take it like that, just support me. And if you haven't seen me in a while, you can always check up on me on Instagram. My name is chidimma.ibinedion on Instagram, so you can just go there and send me a message, follow me and I'll follow back, just really to know how I'm doing. But I can assure you guys that I'm fine. Of course, it's just the work that makes me not come here as often as I would love to. So now into our story, guys. I really goofed, as in I don't even need anyone to tell me that I goofed. At the time I was working in a bank, a very popular bank, and many of you who know me very well watching this video probably know the bank that I worked with. So I was working in the cash and teller unit. Many people dread the cash and teller unit because you could have shortages, you could have overages. For example, you pay out cash, you receive cash, and sometimes you don't count properly. Maybe the person that is depositing money doesn't give you the exact amount he wants to deposit, or you do not count properly, and then you just input it in the system, input the wrong amount into the system, and find out that at the end of the day you are not balancing, your cash drawers are not balancing, or like there's some kind of errors, maybe overages, you have more cash than you should have, or you have less cash than you should have. So in such cases you don't balance. And what many people do in those situations is that where there are shortages, they get to use their own money, like their personal money, to balance out, just so that there's no issue with the bank, there's no issue with the audit department or the disciplinary committee and stuff. So those are the kind of challenges you face when you're in the cash and teller department. Or sometimes some people come in and give you fake notes, like they could give you a fake 1000 naira note, 500 naira note. Under such situations, when you receive cash from customers, the first thing you're supposed to do is to run it through the UV light. I think it's called ultraviolet light. So it gets to show you if the currency is fake or whether it's genuine. So if you mistakenly go and collect fake cash from someone, fake currency, in such cases, you have to declare it, and then you get disciplined by the bank. Or if you don't want issues, you just generally bring out your money and replace the currency, the fake notes that the person paid you. So in the cash and teller department, many times, many tellers have to record losses and stuff. So my first major goofing, my first major experience in that situation was when I had a shortage of 15,000 naira. Like, I was doing well, I was a new person at the bank, and I think I was doing well, like so far so good, there was no issue. Like, I was just taking my time and balancing out, no issue. On one particular day, I don't know what happened, I just had a shortage of 15,000 naira. And I think then I hadn't even received my salary for the month and or more. I was in shock. I went through all my transactions, like I literally scanned everything one by one to check, like at what point did this error occur. But I don't know, man, it just happened and I had to pay with my money. So my supervisors who are watching this video now, yes, I paid with my money. So that was what happened. And then there was another occasion where I think I overpaid a client by 50,000 naira. Then I was working at the airport branch. So we had all these Hausa guys that used to come to do bureau the change, they were money changers. And the truth is that I give it to those Hausa guys, they are very, very honest. So there was this particular person I overpaid. So going through all my transactions for the day, I was checking through, and then I saw where I made the mistake, because at the back of each teller or each withdrawal slip, you get to write the description of how you paid the customer. If you paid in 500 naira notes, you state how many pieces of 500 naira notes you paid. If you paid in 1000 naira notes, you also state how many pieces of 1000 naira notes you paid. So when I checked the description, I saw where my error was coming from. So just before I could even call the customer to tell the customer that I overpaid him, just as I looked up, I saw the customer walking into the bank to come and tell me that I overpaid him by 50,000 naira. And I was like, chest. I was in shock, and I was very grateful to that guy. And that was how he returned the money, and I was able to balance off for that day. Like, I was like, how much is my salary that I'm going to pay 50,000 naira to the bank, eh? Like, am I working? Basically, I was just in shock. I was just wondering, like, what if it was not that outside guy that I paid that money? What if it was just one random person that I was looking for who butter his bread? And then he noticed that I overpaid him by 50,000 naira. The guy would have just been happy. He would have just moved on and called his girlfriend and they'll just flex and then they'll have fun and they'll be like, ah, mugu, that's paid and I'll be the mugu. But anyways, thank God for that situation. The guy really saved me and it was, whew. But that's not the main goofing I'm talking about. So this one is just the normal goofing that happens in the cash and teller department. So the main goofy was when I think somebody in the customer service unit was on leave, I think maternity leave or just a normal leave. And I was called to come and relieve the person in that customer service department. And I was very happy because I was like, I beg, at least goodbye to all these shortages and overages. I beg, let me just even have a break. And that's how I went to the customer service unit. And I was happy, I was having fun. Like, it was like a holiday for me. So I was just basically very excited about it. So I was just taking things slow as usual. And then that's how somebody walked in. You know, the airport, you always see a lot of celebrities, you see musicians, you see actors and actresses. So it was a normal thing for us to see actors and actresses. But me being a newbie, I was kind of starstruck. So I was still like trying to get used to it. There's some things that the video will pass with his entourage and they're all very happy. They're all bouncing and trying to cash around. So it was just a very lovely sight to see sometimes. It was like funny, it was entertaining. Let me just put it that way. So there was this particular day a celebrity walked into the bank, and guys, this guy, I was looking at the guy, I was like, this guy looks like Niedu's ex-husband. He looks like the guy. And I told my supervisor that was sitting right next to me, like, Auntie, this guy, he looks like Niedu's ex-husband. And trust me, I didn't know I was being so loud, and the guy just looked like he was embarrassed. Guys, do you know that that guy was actually Niedu's ex-husband? Like, he was the one in flesh and blood in my front. I was like, and then she pinched me and she was like, don't say that, don't say that. As you go, Chief, you're watching this. I'm so sorry. So that was what happened, and a guy was embarrassed. I was embarrassed. I knew I had goofed. Like, normally I'm not so flippant, but I don't know what came over me. I just, even if I was thinking it in my head, I could have just kept quiet until the guy left. But I just said it out. I'm like, actually, you messed up. Sha, you really messed up. So that's how the guy finished his transaction and then he left. And then my supervisor, Atiguchi, if you're watching this video, you did me dirty. She went and told everybody, like, so guys, this is what she did my trustee. She just said, this guy looks like Niedu's ex-husband. And that's actually Niedu's ex-husband, because when we were processing his transaction or whatever he came to do, and I saw the name, I was like, yay. Like, he's actually the one. Like, what have I done? And so when she told everybody, we were like, everybody, they first of all laughed at me, and I was like, hey God, I'm in trouble. So we're having our usual weekly meetings, like Wednesday meetings, where all the staff of the bank come together and basically call out the activities for the week and then report any issues that may be happening and stuff. So after everything, I knew that I would not go scot-free in that meeting. I knew that they were going to call me and ask me, Auntie, what did you just do? So basically, I was waiting for them to come and crucify me and tell me how much I had messed up and what was going to be my punishment. Like, I was just quiet, like someone that they poured ice water on throughout that meeting. I was just waiting. And then they came, Chidima. I was like, kill me now. And then they started talking, like the head of operations was talking, like, you don't say stuff like that in front of clients. You just wait. Even if you're suspecting that this might be someone, comport yourself, this and that. And then she talked and talked and talked and talked. And I was like, yep, I deserved it. Yep, I deserved it. So I just took my L in peace and I left. And since then, Kai, I was just very, 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 very careful. Like, even if I see celebrities and I'm excited and stuff, you just might poke up and say, so what would you like me to do for you? Serious poker face, no starstruckness, just respect myself and do what I'm supposed to do before I mess up once again. Guys, it was very, very embarrassing. I embarrassed myself, I embarrassed the man, and I'm so sorry if he's watching this video. I'm really, really sorry. Like, it just really came out. So anyways, guys, that's what happened. That's my story time. So I felt like, since I haven't come here to come and show you guys in the world, I could just break the ice with the story time. If you enjoyed my story time and you want more story times like this, please be sure to let me know in the comment section, and I'll be glad to film videos like this. If you have any other video ideas you have for me that you want me to talk about, I'll be very happy to do so. But for now, this is where I'm going to end this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Have a nice day.